Well, for more on this, we're joined by Chris Alexander, a former Canadian diplomat in Russia. He joins us live now from London. Chris, what will this do to already strained relationships, between Canada and China?
Well, it is making those relationships more difficult than ever. It's also changing the perception Canadians had, and I think a broader audience in among China's trading partners had, of what China is and what China wants to be. We're only prepared to invest in and trade with a country on the scale we do and grow that relationship if there's confidence that the rule of law is respected and the rule of law is being more deeply entrenched in China. This indicates that the opposite is happening. It's a retrial. It's clearly retaliation for the arrest of Ms. Meng in Vancouver, who is being considered for extradition to the United States because of legitimate process injustice that has unfolded there. We need to know that China is committed to the rule of law, and the only way to find that out is to drop this arbitrary move against Mr. Schellenberg, as well as the two other Canadians that are still being held.
How far do you think Justin Trudeau would be willing to go in this case? Do you think he would attempt to intervene to get this death sentence dropped? I mean, how far do you think he would be willing to go? Sanctions? I'm not sure. What's on the table here?
Well, I think he's indicated how seriously we all take this today. That's an excellent start. I know there's much more being done behind the scenes. And I think he'll have the support of all Canadians in taking a very firm line on this issue. These are Canadian lives now at stake. And there will be no support in Canada for negotiation, for example, of a free trade agreement with China. So long as this is happening, there will be no support in Canada for Canadian efforts to end the trade war that the United States and others have begun with China. So long as this is happening, it antagonizes a very important constituency for China among its Western partners. And I think the Chinese have radically underestimated how this is negatively impacting their reputation among countries that they need as their economic situation becomes more and more tenuous.
Thanks for that. Good to get your analysis. That's Chris Alexander live from London.